Hello students, hope all of you are safe and fine. Welcome back to Computer Application class, ICSE 6th. Today's topic, Tabular Presentation in Microsoft Word Part 3. In the last class, we learned merging cells and splitting cells, changing the column width and changing the row height. So in the last class we saw how to change the height of a row and how to change the width of the column. After that we saw how to merge a cell and how to split a cell. And that is what we saw in the last class. Today we will see how to apply borders and shading for a tabular column. How to apply borders and shading for tabular column. For example, when you do a timetable for your school, for your class, when you do a timetable, if ma'am, if your miss asks you to do a chart with all the timetable of the scheduled classes, so one student makes the chart. But what does he do? He does not just simply bring his, the timetable. But what does he do? He makes it in a designed way. He colors it. The student puts lots of effort and does lot of designing and everything, like the example I have shown here. Likewise, in the computer also, the tabular column can be made in a beautiful way with lots of different kinds of borders, shading, colors, everything can be done in computer also, in Microsoft Word. When you create a tabular column, it can be designed in a nice way. So we will see how to design or how to apply borders and shading for a tabular column. So this is one of the examples I have given here, like how you do your timetable for school with all the colors and designs, everything. Here this is the timetable. So Monday social studies, then you have yoga, Sanskrit, computer, etc. So we'll see another example also. See here, in this also there is lot of pictures for everything. For maths there is a calculator. For English, books are there, science, all the chemicals and everything is there. So likewise, we make it in a beautiful way. In this way, the tabular column in computers also, in Microsoft Word, can also be designed in a nice way. So this is another example. Here, there are lots of varieties of borders and styles that can be applied to a tabular column. Here I have shown an example which was very different. The example is the ABCD tabular column. That table was, they have selected a particular design. That is why it is looking like this, the borders and everything. So in your computer, how can the appearance of the table can be changed? For that, first you have to select the table. Whichever table it is, you have to select the table. Then table tools will be there. There you have to go and click design tab. There is a, you have to first select the table, then go to table tools. After that, click design table. When you click that design tab, there will be a box of colors and everything I am shown in the next picture, with lots of colors. So you can select any one of these colors and apply it to the table. So if you select the orange one, the table will become orange in color. So click on borders drop down arrow and choose borders and shading at the end of the list. And after that, for borders, you have to again there will be a drop-down list with all the arrows and everything. So you have to go there, choose the borders and chaining, which is at the end of the list. At the end of the drop-down list, there will be an option called borders and chaining. You have to select that, and then you have to select whichever border you would like to apply for the table. So I have just given the steps that you have to follow to design your table. First you have to select the table, then go to table tools. After that you have to select the border drop down list, which is at the end of the list. Borders and shading you have to select and give the whichever you require, whichever design you like, you can click it and apply it to the table. That's all. Here I have shown a table. After the steps, you have to follow these steps. If not, today, nowadays in the new Microsoft Word, if you keep your mouse pointer at the end of the cell, there will be a very small arrow mark. If you keep the pointer there, the borders will appear in a small box at the top of the table. So there also you can select whichever border you want. So that is the recent, in all the recent updated Microsoft Word, you will be able to see this arrow. That I've just given a small example for that, the picture. Next, we'll see how to resize the table. If you think that the table is very small, you can resize it. But how to resize the table? We'll see that. There will be a double arrow mark. So if you keep the double arrow mark at the end of the last cell, last column, last cell, if you keep the double arrow mark, if you keep the pointer at the end of the cell, the double arrow mark will appear. After that, you have to click your mouse, left click your mouse and pull the double arrow mark. If you pull it, the table will resize. It will become bigger or smaller, whichever you want, you can do. If you want to make it smaller, you can pull it towards upwards. If you want to make it bigger, you have to pull it downwards. Pull the arrow downwards. That's all. Very simple. So that is how you have to resize the table. Move the pointer. That handle, double arrow handle will be there. Hold it and bring it to the, drag the mouse and bring it to the bottom. That's all. Your table will be resized. Cell alignment. So now we'll see how to align the cell. Why do you have to align the cell? If you align the cell, it will look very neat. The table will be very neat, and it will also look the appearance will be very enhanced, and it will look very neat. Here, when you align a cell, if you give a text or a number, it will be positioned in how does it get positioned in the cell. That is the cell alignment. There are two types of alignments. First one is the vertical alignment and second one is the horizontal alignment. So vertical alignment is it will tell whether the text is placed at the top or center or bottom of the cell. One cell is there and you have given a text named hello. If you click vertical alignment, what it will do, it will place the hello word either at the top or at the center or at the bottom. So you have to select whichever way you want. If you give top, it'll be aligned in the top. Or if you want it to be in the center of the cell, you can give center. Or if you want it to be at the bottom of the cell, you can give bottom. Then the hello word will be in whichever position you have selected. So what is horizontal alignment? Horizontal alignment is the word hello will be either in the left, right or center. So you have to select which alignment you want. If you want it to be in the right, you can select right or center or left. But default, if you did not select anything, defaultly it will be in the top left. For vertical it will be top, and for horizontal it will be left. That is the default alignment of the cell. If you want, you can change the alignment. So how do you change the alignment? How do you change the cell alignment? I told you can select any alignment you want. So how do you select it? How do you change the alignment? That is, you have to right click and select cell alignment option. There will be an option called cell alignment. You have to right click and select it, and then you have to keep the pointer in the cell, whichever cell you want to align, and then right click, and here and you'll get an option called cell alignment. You have to click there and select whichever option you want, either in the vertical, either you can select top, bottom or center. In the horizontal alignment, you can select either right, left or center. Now we'll see how to change the direction of the text. So what is direction of the text? When you select, when you type a word in the cell, it will be displayed in a horizontal manner. It will be in a straight line, horizontal manner it will be displayed. But if you want the word to be in a vertical manner, what is vertical manner? In the standing position. If you want, if it is hello, when you type it will be H-E-L-L-O. If you want to type it, H at the top, E below the H, L below E, and another L below L, and O below O. So if you want it to be, if you want the text to be in a vertical way, you can change it. So how do you change it? But default it will be horizontal. Just when you keep the pointer in the cell and type it, it will be horizontal. If you want to change it to the vertical, what should we do? We will see how to steps to select it. I will tell you. You have to right click. As usual, you have to keep the pointer in the cell. Right click the cell and select text direction, and then you can change it to vertical. There will be a dialog box, and there you can change whether you want it to be or as usual horizontal, or if you want it to be vertical, you can select it. So that is the end of unit 3. I'll just give a recap of whatever we have seen so far in unit 3. We have seen how to create a tabular presentation in Microsoft Word, creating a table. Then we saw how to enter data, how to enter text into the table. Then we saw how to delete or insert row and column. After giving the data also, we can insert row and column to the table. After that, we saw how to delete a row or column. Then we saw changing the row height and changing the column width. After that, what did we see? We saw merging cells and splitting cells. Then we saw resizing a table. Then we saw applying borders and shading. Finally, we saw cell alignment and text direction. So that's all. Unit 3 is getting over here. So we'll move on to the unit 4. Unit 4, I'll just give an introduction of the Unit 4 topic. It is male merge. It is a very interesting topic. Everyone will be liking it very much. So I'll just give a introduction to male merge topic. So what is male merge? For example, if it is your birthday and you want to invite all your friends. So you have 30 friends and you want to invite all your friends through an email. But what the problem is, you have only one document, only one invitation you have, but you have to send it through email to everyone. So for that you can use mail merge. Okay, that is a very important topic in your syllabus, and this is how you use mail merge. Nowadays you use in WhatsApp, if you want to send a common forward to everyone, you create a group, and in that group you give your forward message. But here you just have to type one invitation, and if you want to send through email, this is the best way. You cannot send in WhatsApp. Email cannot be sent through WhatsApp, but in mail merge you can use using mail merge you can send the invitation to your friend's email ID. So we will see how to create it, how to do it. In the later part we will see how to create it. But here you can create a letter, label, envelope, invitation, and so on. What is needed for this is addressed different recipients. Your friend is the recipient, so you need all your friends' email IDs, that's all. Then you'll need another one, which is the document. The invitation is the document. So you need an invitation, you need all your friends' email IDs, then you have to input the name and address of the name of your friend and his email address, and then merge it into the letter. That is all. So that is mail merge. I will teach you in detail in the later part, later classes, in the forthcoming classes. Now I will just give a brush up of what is mail merge. So I told you what is mail merge. So we will see what are the advantages of mail merge. The advantages are, you can send a common letter to many people. That is the main advantage. Only one invitation, you are going to send it to 30 people at a time. So that is the first advantage. Then, so one document can be sent for bulk mailing. What is bulk mailing? Bulk mailing is you have hundreds of mail IDs. For that you have to send a single invitation. So for that also, this bulk mailing is very mail merge is very useful for bulk mailing. So what is the third advantage? Third advantage is, it is easy to make change in a single document. So you have only one single document, so you are going to send it to all the recipients. So in that one single document you can make lots of changes. It is very easy to change a single document. If you want 30 documents to be sent to 30 recipients, it will be difficult to change the mistakes in each and every 30 invitations. If you have only one invitation, sending it to all the other people, it will be very easy to change, and very easy, and it will not be very difficult. It will be easy to change the mistakes in one invitation. So that is the next advantage. Then one document can be saved and reused for many occasions. It can be saved and it can be edited, and it can be sent for your friend's birthday also. You have one invitation for your birthday, you can save it, then you can edit it for your sister's or your friend's birthday, and again you can send it through mail merge. Final advantage is, it saves a lot of time. You need not keep on typing your invitation, or you need not keep on typing your letter again and again and again for 30 recipients. Instead, just one document is enough. to send it to lots of people. So it also saves lot of time. So these are the advantages. First is common letter to many people. Bulk mailing is it helps in bulk mailing. Then easy to change a single document. Then you can save the document and you reuse it again, and it saves time. So five advantages you have. Next is, we'll see the components of mail merge. So what is a component? What we need for doing mail merge. So what are the three main components of mail merge? There are three components. One is the main document, the letter or the invitation or the envelope. That is the main document. Next is the data source. So what is the data source? Data source is all the name and the email IDs of your recipient, whoever you are going to send the document. Names and email IDs, you'll keep it as a data source. You'll enter it in a data source. Then finally, the merged document, that is the final document, that is the output of what you are doing. So three main components: main document, data source, and merged document. So what is a main document? I already told you, the main document is the letter or invitation we are going to send to other recipients. I'll give you another example here. If your teacher wants to send a common letter to all the students, she wants to tell that tomorrow is a holiday to all the students' parents. She's going to send a letter telling the next day is a holiday to all the parents. She cannot type, if there is 54 students in her class, she cannot type 54 letters and send it to a single recipient. Instead, she can send, she can type a main document, main letter, and send it to all the other 54 students through mail merge. So for that, the main letter is needed. That is the main document. So next, what is data source? We need a data source to send for doing mail merge. First is the main document, then data source. What is the data source? Data source is the information of the recipient. Recipient is the person you are going to send the invitation or letter. So the information of that recipient is very, very necessary. What are the informations that you want from the recipient? His name and address. If it is a student, the student's name and email ID is needed. After that information will be given as input to the Microsoft Word. After that, it will insert the main mail ID, name and mail ID, the data source, into the main document. Inserting the information into the main document. So what is merged document? After inserting the all the mail IDs, the recipient's information into the main document, it becomes a merged document. That's all. So that is the merged document. What does the Microsoft Word do? It replaces the merges the data source and the main document, and it becomes a merged document. That is the work of Microsoft Word. So merged document is the combination of main document and the data source. So that's all about mail merge. In the next class, we'll see how to do this mail merge. We'll type a letter, the document, and we'll demonstrate and see how to do mail merge in the next class. So that's all for today. Hope it was a very interesting class. Unit 3 got over, and unit 4 we have just saw the introduction. I'll send you the questions of unit 3, which you have to write it in your classwork. I will send it, a document will be sent through through WhatsApp group. So you have to write all the questions which are given in that document in your class work note. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.